Good morning, everybody. It's Midnight and Beyond, and it's time for yet another Top 10 video. We just got done with the Let's Play of SpongeBob SquarePants Battle for Bikini Bottom Rehydrated. So, what better way to celebrate that LP wrapping up than with a Top 10 video of my favorite episodes from a completely different show? Yeah, in all seriousness, I have some unfinished business from my Let's Play of Ed, Edd n Eddy the Misadventures. Since my channel was sort of at the time of that LP's production, I never got the chance to make this video like I had originally intended. So I'm finally getting around to it right here. And to those of you who think I should be making a top 10 video on my favorite SpongeBob episodes, I've already done that. Link to that video is in the description. But today, it's all about the Ed Boys. Now, even though I think SpongeBob was the more impactful show throughout my childhood, I honestly had a much harder time coming up with a list of only 10 episodes to choose from this legendary Cartoon Network show. There's truly nothing else like it, and every single second of every single episode is filled to the brim with memorable moments and brilliant writing, accompanied by fantastic music and an amazing ensemble that stuck with me for years. It wasn't easy, but I think I have my top 10 favorite episodes ready to share with all of you. Feel free to let me know what your favorite episodes are in the comments. And don't worry, if you're like me and don't actually remember any of the episodes by their episode titles since they're also samey, I'll be sure to be descriptive with them so that you know which one I'm talking about. Without further ado, here are my top 10 favorite episodes of Ed, Edd n Eddy. Number 10, Ed or Tails, aka the episode where Ed gets two free jawbreakers in the mail and has to find a way to share them between him and his two friends. Ed is without question my favorite character in the show. As a kid, it was a tie between him, Plank, and Rolf, but now that I'm older, I think I've grown to appreciate the complexity in his character so much more. I know what you're thinking, Ed, complex? But hear me out on this, because the writing on the show is seriously beyond brilliant. Not just with its comedic bits, but also with really touching moments that are just as quick-paced as the funny ones, so you might not be able to pick up on it right away. So after Ed opens his package and shows off the jawbreakers to his friends, Eddie and Double D immediately see the problem in which there isn't enough for all three of them to enjoy. They try to get Ed to figure it out, which takes him a literal day to come to the conclusion all on his own. And I get it, Ed is stupid, we all know that. But what I love about the scene is what happens once he finds out. It took him a literal day to figure out that two jawbreakers wasn't enough for three people. But the literal second he realizes that, he immediately, without hesitation, gives the two jawbreakers to his friends without a second thought. That is what I love about Ed. He's a pure, lovable character who may not be the brightest of the bunch, but his heart is always in the right place. His friend's happiness is his happiness, and that's something I've always been able to resonate with, as I'm always at my happiest when I'm with the people I care about. This one scene is a perfect example of the brilliance crammed into each and every second of this show, and I can't sing enough praises about it. Number 9, Little Ed Blue, aka the episode where Ed gets mad. Okay, so remember when I said that Ed is a pure, lovable character? Well, that changed drastically in this episode. Ed is furious, and no one knows why. It ends up being because a pebble was stuck in his shoe and it made him stink and snap for some reason, but throughout the entire episode where other characters are completely in the dark, our lovable, cheerful goofball is nowhere to be found. I remember feeling really sad when seeing this episode for the first time. Well, before that, I was really stinking happy when I saw that this was the one and only episode where Ed fought back against Sarah and actually got her to back off. That was so sick and satisfying considering how much of a despicable jerk she is throughout the show. But when Ed is in this slump, I was worried for him. Just like how Ed's joy brings joy to the people around him, his sadness does the same. When rewatching the show for the LP, I was actually kind of surprised to remember just how many episodes of the show there were that made me cry or get emotional as a kid. I wouldn't expect that from a show filled with such hilarious, ludicrous characters, but they all have their moments of vulnerability and insecurity, and I guess that really resonated with me back then. I was a very obnoxious and jokish child, but could easily get shut down completely when something bad occurred in my life. I cried a lot, and it took a long time for me to bounce back, and I guess seeing that even characters like these, who are seemingly endless supplies of positive, funny energy, are also capable of reaching their breaking points, I don't know, it just stuck out to me. And I definitely appreciated that being showcased in the show surprisingly frequently. But on a more brighter note, this episode also has a lot of hilarious moments in it. Like this being the one time in the show where Eddie and Kevin actually get along for a little bit. Kevin starts throwing a baseball at Ed's head just for fun because he's not reacting to it. And as soon as Eddie sees it, he yells out, "Pass it here, Kev!" And the two of them just start bonding over it by throwing the baseball against Ed's head together. And it's just stinking hilarious to see that happen, because Eddie and Kevin never get along. And of course, there's also the hilarious scene where Eddie and Double D are looking through Ed's things and trying to find things that'll cheer him up, and Eddie finds one of Ed's magazines. The contents of that magazine are, shall we say, hilarious. And any moment in the show where Double D is left speechless is always a hilarious moment. Number 8. They call him Mr. Ed, aka the episode where the Eds are all obsessed with the concept of up. As we get further through this list, you'll notice that I like a lot of the gimmicky episodes of Ed, Edd, and Eddy. To this day, I still don't entirely understand what the episode is supposed to be about. The Eds are trying to move up in the world, so they start a business about the concept of up, and hire on other cul-de-sac kids to help them in their endeavors of achieving up status, while proceeding to incorporate the word up into all of their conversations. On paper, it sounds like a late season episode of a show that's run out of ideas and is just trying to solve for time. SpongeBob. But Ed, Edd, and Eddy never ran into that problem. While I do think the last season of that show is the worst of the bunch, it never quite reaches SpongeBob levels of scratching the bottom of the barrel. I would use the phrase shark jumping, but in all honesty, that's every episode of Ed, Edd, and Eddy. It's all a non-stop ride of insanity that all sort of blends together in my memory. What was I talking about again? Oh yeah, up. I like how Ed is just sort of absent throughout the episode and is just building an elevator in the background. I like how because the Eds have to lose at the end of each episode, the thing that becomes their downfall, pun intended, is simply Kevin showing up and saying the word down in a bunch of his sentences. I don't know, it's just one of those episodes that you can't really describe. It's a good example of how this show can do literally everything with absolutely nothing. If you seriously haven't seen the show, what's up with that? Yeah, I tried. Number 7, Wish You Were Ed, aka the episode where Rolf is homesick. Speaking of things that can't be easily described, hello Rolfie boy! This is another example of an episode that takes a happy-go-lucky character reaching their breaking point. Rolf feels out of place in the cul-de-sac and wishes he could return to his hometown. I remember being kind of worried when I first saw this episode, thinking that Rolf was actually going to end up leaving the show. I blame Steve from Blue's Clues for all those fears and insecurities about characters leaving when I thought they'd be with me forever! But thankfully that wasn't the case here, and it's all just a setup for another scam from the Ed Boys. We never really figure out where exactly Rolf is from, but this is the closest we ever got. The thing that really sells this episode for me is the iconic "That's my horse!" scene. I'm sure every kid who grew up watching the show tried to do this dance with their siblings or their friends and got in trouble for it because they would take it too far and would end up hurting each other and blah 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 parenting. Maybe that's why so many kids at my school told me they weren't allowed to watch the show growing up, but whatever. I still really enjoyed this episode. I like when the Eds are trying to do something kind for someone else, even if they're not all totally in agreement on that decision, and while it does end up being a traditional bad ending scenario for the Eds, I was happy to see Rolf find happiness with where he was in the end. We're happy to have you, buddy. Number 6. Who, What, Where, Ed, aka the episode where the Eds gotta do a bunch of trades in order to obtain a single egg from Rolf. It's the obligatory fetch quest episode. Every show and video game has to have a fetch quest in it, right? Well, at least for this one, it's a TV show, so we don't actually have to be the ones doing any of the work. This is the episode that actually introduces Ed's love for chickens, as well as Eddie's apparently legendary omelet-making skills. I still wish I could have tried one of those. Makes you wonder why he never tried selling those to the neighborhood kids if they're as good as he says they are. I really like the episodes that showcase the entire cast of characters within them, so that definitely contributes to my enjoyment of this episode. Ed asking Rolf where eggs come from and then Rolf getting ready to show him directly where is always such a pleasant thing to remember. When trying to recall just exactly what was the cause of you losing your childhood innocence, I guess. I think this was also the first episode that acknowledges the existence of other people living in the cul-de-sac. When they're looking for clams, they start going door to door asking if anyone has clams, but to no avail. While we don't see any of the people that they're talking to, it's presumably not the regular cast members, as we see all of them at different points throughout the episode. So I guess there goes the theory of all of them being dead and living in limbo. I seriously don't even know why that's a thing. It's a stinking cartoon! They look weird because it's a drawing! Seriously. But yeah. Fetch quest. Chicken funny. Egg. Moving on. Number 5. 1 plus 1 equals Ed. AKA everyone else's favorite episode. AKA the one where the Eds alter reality. Now we're in the real meat and potatoes of this list. Honestly, I'd go as far as to say that the top 5 episodes on this list are all tied for first place. To say I had trouble ranking them all is a massive understatement, so don't hate me too much with having this one at number 5. I stinkin' love this episode. It's definitely Ed, Edd, and Eddy's creativity at its absolute best. From the visuals to the gags, it's brilliant all the way through. I remember the way I used to describe this episode to others as a kid was that I would say it was the only episode of Ed, Edd, and Eddy that wasn't realistic. that every other episode had totally normal events and actions that could be replicated in real life, and that this was the one episode that was supernatural. And to that I say, what the fruit kind of chunky puffs was I chewing back then? I seriously thought the rest of the show was normal? Guess that says something about how my mind works or something like that. But yeah, it's an episode, alright. I don't really know how to describe it, but if you've seen it, you know what I'm saying. Or maybe you don't. I don't know, I'm not a poet. Number 4, And Ed Is Born, aka the episode where Eddie tries to film a movie to send to his brother. One of the highlights of Ed and Eddie is no doubt the music. It is so fantastic and set the bar for every show that aired alongside it at the time and every show that came after it. Seriously, I could be here all day talking about how brilliant the music and sound design is in this show. So why the heck do I have the one episode with little to no music in it as number 4 on this list? Better yet, why the fruit was it my favorite episode as a child? Well, for the absence of music comes with a lot of interesting elements that can't be found in any other episode. When Eddie begins filming the movie for his brother, the rest of the episode is filmed in a POV angle from the video camera's perspective. The music is also completely absent from this point onward to give it a more realistic feel to it. It was purposely made to feel like a mediocre home movie that was made by a kid with a camera and no sense of filmmaking comprehension. The fact that the lack of music in this episode is so jarring in the first place ironically speaks volumes to just how good the soundtrack is in the rest of the show. The POV shots are also really well put together. I also love how the running gag is just having the Eds accidentally slash intentionally making Rolf stinkin' angry throughout the entire episode. And of course, any episode that mentions Eddie's brother is always a treat. It was by far the most elusive element of watching the show back in the day, constantly wondering if we would ever get to see his brother and what kind of person he was like. I'm glad we finally got that closure in the actual movie, but this home movie is a bit more personal to me, so that's why it's ranked so high on this list. Number 3, Don't Rain on My Ed, aka the episode where there's free jawbreakers at the candy store and the Eds only have 10 minutes to get there before the store closes. When getting ready to make this list, I had this episode in my mind as my favorite episode of Ed, Edd n Eddy. Of course, that no longer turned out to be true, but like I said, the top 5 are all kinda tied for me, so it still kinda is. What I love about this one is the fact that it gave me so much hope that they would finally get their stinking jawbreakers. I'm always rooting for the Eds, and I was hopeful that this would finally be their happy ending episode. There was no scam involved, no manipulation, the only thing stopping them from succeeding was their lack of cooperation. Which I guess is the case in a lot of episodes, honestly, and I guess that explains why they didn't succeed in the end. But I love the heartwarming moment where they are so close to the candy store and Eddie finally comes to realize that he can't make it there alone. Ed steps up to the plate and has one of the most epic faces in Ed history, and manages to get them through the storm. And to this day, I could perfectly hear the line of Double D saying, "You see, Eddie, any obstacle can be overcome when we work together as a team!" It just makes me so happy to hear that, for how wacky these characters are, for how cynical this show could be at times, for how much these guys can never catch a break. They always have each other, and that's what keeps them going. I wish I could say this episode has a happy ending, but unfortunately, Eddie is left with the choice of either helping his friends from drowning in chickens, or entering the candy store on his own. His hesitation shows that he does have a conscience, he isn't completely heartless, but unfortunately he makes the wrong choice this time and suffers the consequences for his actions. Oh well, he'll come around someday, but that day is sadly not today. Still a great episode though. Number 2, If It Smells Like an Ed, aka the episode where they get framed for ruining Friendship Day. This is my first episode of Ed, Edd n Eddy. I'll be honest, I avoided this show like the plague when I was a kid. I saw quick glimpses of it when flicking through the channels back in the day and just thought it looked really gross. I couldn't stand the character designs or the art style and I didn't even attempt to give this show a fair chance. But one day during summer break when I had nothing else to do and was desperate for something to watch on TV, I went through all the channels and there was absolutely nothing that interested me. The only thing that felt even mildly tempting was Ed, Edd n Eddy. I wound up giving in and watched my very first episode from beginning to end. That was this episode, and it cemented my love for this series for many years to come. It's certainly a weird episode to get introduced to the series with. It's a full-length 22-minute episode as opposed to the usual 11-minute format that each episode typically followed. But it did a great job at introducing me to the entire cast of characters and giving me an understanding on what the show is all about. The twist reveal at the end is stinking incredible, and I felt really happy that the episode was actually referenced right at the end of the Big Picture Show movie. Right as the credits are about to roll, the characters begin to sing the Friendship Day song that originated from this episode. It was just such a perfect heartwarming feeling that my first memory with Ed, Edd n Eddy wound up also being one of my very last. It's the episode that drew me into this legendary show and made me never look back, so of course I had to make it onto this list. However, there's still one episode I think I could hold in just slightly higher regard than all the rest. What episode is that? Well, before we reveal that, let's go over the honorable mentions. Oh boy, this'll be fun. The one with the boomerang, the Valentine's Day episode, the one where Ed's grounded, the one where Johnny and Plank split up, the one where Ed thinks Double D is an alien, the one where they have a bunch of flashbacks of things that never actually happened in any episode of the previous shows, the one where they try to catch a balloon, the one where they go to the beach, the one where the Eds pretend to be one another, the one where they're stuck in the wall, the one where they deliver newspapers, the one where they worship Kevin, the one with Plank's parents, the one where Ed loses a tooth, the one where they take pictures of everyone and Rolf turns into a wiener, the one where Ed is sleepwalking and murders Jim, the one where Eddie goes on a date with Naz, the one with the haunted house, the one where Plank tries to murder the Eds, the one with the stuck quarter, the one where Eddie and Plank run for King of the Cul-de-Sac, the one where they try to decipher a map left by Eddie's brother, the one with Captain Melonhead, the one where Eddie is trying to hide his porn stash, and the Ed, Edd n Eddy Big Picture Show movie! And finally, my favorite episode of Ed, Edd n Eddy. Number 1, Ed, Edd n Eddy's Jingle Jangle Jangle, the Christmas special. I'm sure this is a controversial pick for favorite episode, but hear me out on this. It has all of the characters in the episode, which I always like, it's a gimmicky, unconventional episode, which I'm always a fan of, and it's also the first episode of the entire series to actually feature another character in the show that isn't one of the kids, and that character is stinking Santa Claus of all people. Seeing that for the first time and hearing his voice in the show was magical for a variety of reasons, and it features one of the most emotional moments in the entire series. I watch this Christmas special every single year, and it always manages to make me cry. I was heartbroken for Eddie when he was at the end of his rope and came to realize that not only is he without any presents on Christmas, he doesn't have any friends. He's all alone and he has no one left to blame but himself. Everyone who gave him the time of day and tried to help him only ever gave up on him because of his actions, and he finally realizes that now. So now that he's left with nowhere to go, no place to belong on Christmas Eve, he comes across a Christmas tree with a burnt out bulb. He just so happens to have a replacement bulb in his pocket that Ed had placed there at the beginning of the episode, and he decides to replace the broken bulb with his fresh new one. No dialogue is in this scene, no witty banter or funny gags, just a simple, unselfish gesture from the most cynical and selfish character in the entire show. The first act of kindness he's ever shown, completely of his own free will, and with nothing to gain in return. It wasn't for another person, but it was something that was on the verge of breaking, just like he was. And he didn't want that feeling of brokenness to persist in something else, because he knows what it feels like. So he put a stop to it, and brought light to that once cold and lonely Christmas night. It's such a small gesture, but the significance is not lost on those who bore witness to it. It's enough to bring Double D and Ed to tears, because they knew he had it in him. They believed to the very end that he had a kind heart. It took some time, but he finally came to discover not only the true meaning of Christmas, but the true meaning of finding your family and becoming content with your place of belonging in the world. And then it all gets ruined when he steals the presents from Santa and gets locked away with the cankers as punishment. I wish the Eds had gotten a break for the Christmas special of all things, especially since I believe that they truly earned it this time around. But sadly, that didn't end up being the case. Despite my bitterness towards those last few seconds of the episode, the impact of that one scene with Eddie and the tree have always stuck with me. It brought me to tears and was a testament to how attached I had gotten to these characters. It's a perfect example of how something so ludicrously silly could also have such deep meaning within it. It's something I like to show to people who scoff at cartoons and think they're completely one note and a complete nonsensical waste of time, and try to prove them wrong when showing them that there is deeper meaning to these things than meets the eye. It's all just a matter of giving it a chance. I wanted the best for these characters and I cared for their well-being. It was a long time coming, but I'm glad that they finally got their happy ending when all was said and done. It may not have been this holiday, but here's hoping that they finally got that Merry Christmas later down the line, after the events of the Big Picture Show. And there you have it. Those are my top 10 favorite episodes of Ed, Edd n Eddy. Once again, I'd love to hear what your favorite episodes are, so feel free to let me know in the comments below. There will never be another show like this one. It's truly one of a kind and something I'm forever grateful to have experienced from beginning to end. Thank you for all the wonderful memories, Ed and Eddie, and thank you all for enjoying these quirky TV show-based video game Let's Plays. While this may be the last one you'll ever see on this channel, I'm glad I got to share my love of these shows with all of you. But for now, it's on to something new. Thank you all so much for watching. This is Midnight and Beyond, and I will see you all later. Good night.